Hej, nu ska vi ta och titta lite på de vapen de använde i Hobbit. Det är många sorter, en del är väldigt tunga och hårda och en del är väldigt mjuka, stuntsvärd. Och här är Peter som gjorde vapnen.
Hello. Probably it's easiest if we start by looking at something like Gandalf's sword, but it shows some of the issues that we have to deal with. Now, I'm the specialist sword maker, so my particular thing is this is the spring steel sword that we call the hero version. And so it's all real, apart from being blunt. It's to make it a bit safer for the actors. So this is what they use in close-ups. They don't fight with them because of continuity issues, and these are quite expensive.
Yeah.
So when they're fighting, we have what we call the stunt version.
Okay.
Aluminium blade, same as the steel, but it's a lot lighter, as you can feel. Yeah. And the handle is molded off the original and then reproduced in urethane plastic with a very good paint job.
Yeah.
And if they're good, you could only tell the difference when they're side by side.
Yeah. But so de här är mycket lättare, de här de använder att slåss med.
But what makes this complicated on the Hobbit is we've got three different races, humans, dwarves and hobbits. And sometimes you do it with computer magic to create scale differences. But sometimes the easiest thing is you have a human actor, obviously, for every role. But sometimes the easiest way is we put a scale double beside them, either small scale or large scale, which means we have to scale equipment. So when Gandalf is standing beside a dwarf, his double carries a bigger sword. If he's standing beside a hobbit, he's carrying an even bigger sword.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. So, and it goes the other way too, with hobbits and dwarves standing beside either other hobbits, dwarves or humans. So it gets quite complicated.
Yeah, it's a lot to do with scale.
Yes, oh, very much. And if we come down here, the other main weapon that's new in The Hobbit is Orcrisp, which is carried by Thorin. This is what you or I would carry.
Yeah.
So this is a good-sized cleaving sword. But because Richard Armitage is playing a dwarf, he's got to carry a sword that's been scaled up. And this is the hero steel sword, which is
really
quite
heavy.
Heavy.
Yeah.
Yep. It's steel, there's no way to make it lighter.
So how much does it weigh?
I think it's about 4 kilos.
Yeah.
So it's pretty hefty.
Yeah.
And he doesn't want to carry that for too long.
No.
It's aluminium, it's not too bad.
No.
We have the scale version as well, and this is just rubber.
Yeah.
We have various other pieces. This is a very heavy piece.
Ooh.
So this is fiberglass,
no.
This is the lightweight that Dwalin can carry on his back.
Yeah.
So this is just to take the pressure off the off the actors.
That one looks fierce.
This is this is the largest prop I think we almost made for the entire film. So this is not too bad, not too heavy. This is a soft one.
Yeah.
So
you won't get hurt.
And then we also do alloy blade and then the stunt version.
Yeah.
So these were very useful for fights with a lot of actors.
So there are a lot of versions of all of them. Yeah.
Many. I think by the end of the third film, we will have made more props for The Hobbit than for Lord of the Rings, which is saying a lot. There's a lot of props.
Yeah. Så att det finns svärd av alla sorter, både hårda och tunga och lättare som man kan bära och plast som man kan böja och små och stora. Så många varianter är det. Thank you very much.
Not a problem.